All right. Scarborough schools, like others across the state, are dealing with tough decisions as they cope with cutbacks in funding from the state. But it's another issue that parents, teachers, and administrators are talking about. The Scarborough superintendent informed the high school principal, Patricia Conant, that the board would not renew her contract at the end of this school year. Now, while there are questions surrounding that decision, it appears the board may have acted inappropriately during a closed-door session to talk about Principal Conant's employment with the district. Now, joining us now to talk about this story, reporter Randy Billings with The Forecaster. Thanks again for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
This Sunday. And bring us up to date on this, because as I understand, when you talk about an employee and their contracts, it should be behind closed doors.
That is the case. State law allows a board to go behind closed doors to talk about a personnel issue if that discussion is reasonably expected to harm that employee's reputation. The issue with this was Pat Conant, the principal at Scarborough High School, was actually at the public portion of the meeting, and when the board voted to go into the closed session, the wording of their private meeting, which needs to indicate the precise nature of their meeting, was so vague that she didn't know that they were going behind closed doors to talk about her. And state law allows that when an employee's the discussion of that conversation, they have a right to be there, or they have a right to have some kind of representative there in their place, and that didn't appear to have happened this time.
Okay, so but there is some disagreement about whether the board followed those rules or not. So, would you be able to dig up on that?
Well, at first, when I talked to the Scarborough superintendent, he said he didn't want to discuss it because it was a personnel issue, and after insisting that I was only trying to get at the process. He still didn't want to talk about it, but I did talk to some of the school board members, and they said that meeting did in fact take place at the executive session, and the board members also didn't know what employee was going to be discussed there too. So it doesn't seem like they followed the notice requirement, first of all, and second of all, they didn't seem to have given her right to be there and represent herself in that discussion.
Now, what is the next move for the principal? And were you able to speak with her, and what is she able to share?
Absolutely. Well, she said the decision to not be reappointed next year took her by surprise. She had nothing but favorable conversations with the school board members and the principal. She could file a grievance and try to get her job back, but she's already indicated that she doesn't want to do that because you can't be an effective leader of a school without having the full support. The other option is legal recourse through the Maine Principals Association. She said she hasn't closed her mind to that yet. And then another option is she could waive her right to privacy and ask that the discussion that took place behind closed doors be conducted in public. So we'll see what happens.
Okay. Randy Billings, thanks for coming in. It'll be interesting to see how this all works out. And you can check out your article in The Forecaster. Some other articles you can check out in this week's edition. The feds will fund Portland International Marine Terminal work, but skip the cruise ship Megaberth. That's interesting. And Cumberland residents to vote Tuesday on borrowing $4.5 million for Route 88 upgrades. If you travel that road, you know what we're talking about. Shannon?
All right.